So you, Ahmed, right at the very beginning, is not going to set up Ahmed Real Estate Corporation to buy one investment property.
Yeah.
Right. And why, when it comes to financing, right, you're more likely, it will be easier when it comes to getting financing if you're buying an investment property under your personal name.
Yeah.
So when it comes to setting it up the right way, two things, right? One, to get better favorable terms or better favorable interest rate, right? You can purchase it as owner-occupied, which means you, I mean, is buying an investment property. Investment property, you live in it, you rent out another unit, something like that.
Okay.
Right?
That's the best way.
Yes. That's one way you can structure it as owner-occupied. So you set up all of the insurance, you close the deal with the lawyer, as though you are moving in the property to live, but it's a rental property. If you're renting out the basement or another second unit in the property, if it is more than one apartment in one property. Now the second thing is, you can purchase it as an investment property, right? Because as of was April 20th, 2017, right, with the Fair Housing Plan and all of those measures, the 60 measures, right, one of the rules when it comes to when you're buying a property, you have to disclose are you buying it as your principal residence or are you buying it as your investment property. So when you buy the first property, and when it comes time to closing deal with the lawyers, so the lawyer's job is to pretty much close everything, right, and then Ahmed, you know, goes on title that his property is purchasing, right, you have to sign a paper now that says, is it your, are you occupying the property as your principal residence, or is it investment property, right? So it's one of the things you have to disclose, and that rule came about because we had a lot of the government wanted to trap all these foreign buyers, right, who were buying properties, started, you know, that's in Vancouver, now you have more in Montreal. And wanted to keep track of, you know, who gets the money flowing and etc. So people who were buying properties, they had to disclose, even if they were buying in corporations, they had to disclose all of the names, right, in a corporation, right, if you're buying it as under your personal name, you have to disclose your intention.
Right.
Are you buying it as investment property or principal residence? Right. Okay. So just, you know, more transparency.
Right.
So you don't get